Hey guys, welcome to today's video. If you want to know how to get this glamorous look, we're setting trends here with two different eye shades, then please just keep watching. You guys, I was actually like pre-trying the makeup that I'm about to try, trying to figure out really what colors I wanted to go with and theme things out. So if you saw my most recent PR unboxing, which I will link below, there are over 70 boxes. I don't know if we're even gonna get through them all. Let's take another brief moment at the aftermath, which I couldn't even confront. I literally shut the door on the studio and I was like, bye, I'm getting a snack with Puka. I'm gonna take a break and then this will be my evening. Hello. Oh my gosh. What do you think, Pook? What do you think? What do you think? Okay, let's go take a break, yeah? You want a snack? Let's go have a snack. I mean, it was 3 hours of unboxing product and I laid everything out. I did a huge giveaway, PS, so make sure that you enter the giveaway. Ring my bell, be subscribed, do all of those things. It's not an iPhone. I will never give away an iPhone. I'm not gonna message you about an iPhone. Let's get that out of the way. But I do giveaways when I verbally announce them here on my channel. That's how you know it's legit and real. So I was laying everything out and I realized I had enough for a full meal deal, like full face of awesomeness. And we're just gonna get started. I need to take off what I'm wearing right now because I look amazing. How are you guys doing? What's new? What's going on in your world? Leave it below. What shows are you watching? I think I'm gonna get into American Idol this year. I'm like really into that for some reason. But what else are you guys into? What are your hobbies? What are you doing? Tell me everything. I have been, I don't know, just kind of in creative mode and doing a lot for Halo. It's going so well, you guys. We are inching closer to some really big announcements, so stay tuned. I could not be happier about them. I'm also so into my workouts right now, you guys. Oh my gosh. I am having actual success with my workouts and it is so just satisfying. And I don't know, like visually watching myself change through the IG stories, because I post my workouts, I usually post like a little clip from each circuit that I do. And seeing the progress has done something to my brain to make me just want to go harder and work more and put more in. And my trainer, Rebecca, who is also a friend of mine, like she's just incredible. She's just super encouraging and things are good on that front. So that's kind of been my hobby. Okay, let's do this. I have a new primer to test out from Wander Beauty. This is the Smooth Saline Perfecting Primer. This is said to smooth and mattify, minimize pores, love that. And it blends seamlessly into the skin and this does contain gold. Okay, I'm up for a fancy primer. You know, I haven't used my Guerlain one in ages. Let's see. It's thick. Does not smell like anything like that. All right, let's just kind of smear this into the skin. This feels very gel-like, a little tacky, and it might be my speed. What? Okay, how do my pores look? Let's find that out. Where's my mirror? Mirror, mirror. Effing FFF. It's in front of my face. I'm having one of those days where, have you ever had the like, where are my keys? Why doesn't anyone help me? And like you're holding them, like that's me right now. We're gonna go straight into foundation and we're gonna use a Wander Beauty sponge. This color I just really, really love. I am into beauty sponges that have that nice edge that can help you to contour. And I've never used a sponge or tool from Wander Beauty, so why not? We're also gonna take the Flawless Radiance Perfecting Foundation. Laura Mercier has some of my very favorite of all time foundations, and I have been curious about this one. I don't know how intensely luminous it's gonna be. We are gonna set with powder. We're just gonna figure it out together.
Oh my god.
Oh my gosh, this sponge, it turned into the size of my head. What? This is like, wow. Grower, not a shower. Whoa. This is even more than like the beauty blender. Cashew and cream. That actually looks about right. No. We're going to go in with the shade Cashew. I hope it's not too luminous. That's my only thing. The sponge makes so much noise. Oh my God. I am like haunted. I retweeted a Lady Gaga, like kind of like a meme. And first off, James was like, how could you? Like, you love her. And I'm like, it was funny. It's just funny. It's like really bad lip singing. And I think it's the funniest thing ever, except for now I'm haunted and I have Shallow stuck in my head, but it is not the right version. It's all I'm thinking of. Just so you know, as I'm sitting here blending, it's all I hear. I did it to myself. I'm sorry, Gaga. Is fresh. This is good. What? Stop it. I need to know more about what this is. Hold on. Wow. Ooh. Okay. It says that it's a luminous liquid foundation, that it is going to hydrate, it is weightless, it is medium to full coverage, it's going to give you a perfectly glowing finish in any light, and this is good for normal, dry, combination, and oily. I cannot believe they recommend this for oily, even though it's more of like a dewy finish. This is not a matte finish. And it has silver ear mushroom extract. Don't really know what that is, but I'll take it. Crystal clear pearls that are of a super fine texture. Vitamin C to help brighten your complexion. I don't know in foundation if that's really stable, or you usually have to have vitamin C in a darker container to, you know, maintain its effectiveness. I'm gonna go in with just a little bit more on the areas that I feel like I want just a hit more. You guys know how I do. I'm normally not this impressed right away with the foundation, but I am impressed. All right, we're gonna go right into Frankie Rose Cosmetics. They have their Our Little Secret Concealer. I'm gonna go in with the shade Natural. I have tried this before, I like it. For some reason, when they send me new stuff, I always get confused of if it is a newer formula or an older formula, because a lot of their packaging looks very, very similar. But this is a really nice brand. They make one of the greatest matte foundations. And we're just gonna, you know, keep with the new PR theme and conceal with this guy right here. Ooh, I like this. Okay, now we are going to set the under eye area. I do have another Frankie Rose product. This is their contour kit. I kind of love it, I kind of don't. I don't know, we're giving it a try. I'm gonna take the middle shade and just dust it under here. Ooh, this skin looks so nice. I cannot. And I'm going to take a fluffy powder brush. This is from Smashbox. This is the sheer powder. I'm gonna take a Frankie Rose pressed powder in Spice, grab a little product, and just dust lightly everywhere, just to set the foundation. I need to bake. I just need like a little bit. What I want to do is actually bronze up the face before I go in and contour. Kind of a backwards thing, but I personally love breaking as many rules as I can when doing my makeup. I just kind of have found a routine that really works for me, and that's what I stick with. And I always say this, explore, it washes off. Figure out, you know, the steps that work for you the best. Like, think of what you're trying to achieve and go after that instead of the rules. You're the author of your face. You know, you get to do what you want. You want to bronze and then contour? Go for it. This is the Perfector Face Palette in Light Medium. I'm gonna take what they call the contour and just kind of continue over top my bronzing journey. Well, this is quite nice. I like it. I'm taking an Anastasia crease brush and just kind of going down the sides of my nose, adding a little shape. I'm not sure that I liked the illuminating bronzer as much as I like the matte one from Pure, because I feel like the matte one is actually, not that it's shimmery, but it just has like a creamy finish to it where it's not shiny, it's just creamy, and that's what I like. This one was a little to blend, was not the greatest ever in the world. I don't hate it, but I don't love it. This is great. Like, this is actually blending so nicely. I want to dust off my bake. So we're going to go ahead and do that. This foundation is just like goals. I'm going to go in with this cute as can be Zoella and ColourPop pressed powder blush. And this is in the shade Soulmate. This is super cute. I'm just going to take my Scott Barnes brush, grab the color on the side. This is a really sweet color. Like, it has a little bit of a sheen to it. So it's not entirely matte. It has like this little sheen. I like this. Super cute packaging, really pretty color. I'm gonna do a hit of the blush shade from Cover FX, which is much more pigmented. So I'm gonna make sure to tap a lot of that off and just really lightly go right here. It's like bonus blush time. And then I want to just kind of smooth everything out. We are gonna dive into one of the most beautiful, unexpected, for me, to love shades, and I am so into this. It is kind of what got me excited to sit down and film today, like as I was playing with everything and just like checking out colors, I was like, ooh, we need to film this like right now. I'm gonna wear it today. Why don't I just get ready and hit record? So here we are. I'm gonna wear the shade Soirée from Laura Mercier. This is the most beautiful orangey, gorgeous matte. I am so impressed with this. You don't need a liner. You don't need anything. It goes on like a dream. Wow. I mean, is that not like such a stunning, stunning color. I love this shade so much. Now that we're out of the danger zone with powder and foundation and all of that, I'm going to put on the rest of my jewelry, pop on some eyebrows off camera, because you guys know. And the surprise of the day is that my brows went on beautifully without much of a challenge, even though I am completely out of my favorite eyebrow pencil, the Neutral Nana from Urban Decay. I still use the kind of felt tip side, but I ended up going back to an old favorite, the Anastasia Brow Wiz in Soft Brown. Moving right along. I'm gonna take this guy from Pure. This is the Lit Mist. It is an illuminating setting spray that is going to defend you from your phone, from blue light. Now we're going to take a little bit of Painterly Paint Pot. So we're gonna play with the new Naked Reloaded. They took away the original Naked and they came back with something freshly naked. And it looks really good. I'm excited. I'm gonna take an Urban Decay Smoky Crease Brush and we are first gonna go in with Boundaries. All right, you guys, the shadow is on. I'm loving this look so much. I love the lip even more now that I did this kind of bronzy type of a thing on my lid. I was gonna do a winged liner. That might be dangerous. Maybe, let's find out what happens. Sometimes my hand just like does what it wants to when it comes to liner. Anybody else? It just like, you never really know. So we're gonna go in with this Power Up Butter London Liner, nice itty bitty felt tip applicator. That might be great. I do want to share with you guys that this is really nice. Very dusty, good to blend though. Like, it did blend really evenly, really easily. Just a really solid palette with basically everything you would need for an everyday basic look or smoky look. And while I'm doing my liner, why don't we just do a good old swatch session and go through the whole thing? You have fatter pans on both sides of the palette. So we're gonna start over with Bribe, and then you go into Barely Baked, Angel Fire, Retro, Reputation, Burn, Endgame, Dreamweaver, Distilled, Bucked, Boundaries, and Blur. Ooh, I had abandoned the whole wing liner thing for a minute, and I'm kind of back in it, full on, like full on. I love it. This liner is really nice. It's a little bit, it's not dry, but it takes a minute with pressure for the liquid to come out. So at first I was like, what's going on? But it actually gives you a lot of control. And I feel like I got this to apply pretty quickly, and I'm very, very happy with it. So now what we need to do, I am gonna pop something in the waterline. I wanna take from the Zoella collection with ColourPop. I'm gonna take this shade Sincerely Yours, which is just a rich espresso brown, and I'm gonna line my waterline. I'm gonna try the Marc Jacobs primer before I go in with mascara, so let's keep our fingers crossed. I have high hopes for this. Wow. Okay, YSL slash Marc Jacobs. These are some lashy lashes, right? But I still want more. So we are gonna put on some pretty big lashes just cause why not? I really wanna try these. These are the Kitty Lashes from Flutter Lashes, and we're just going for it. I feel transformed, you guys. This is the most insane look for me. It is really loud both on the lips and the eyes, but I actually really, really love it. Let me know in the comments what you guys think. I want to wrap this up. I am missing highlight, which, oh my gosh, we're not ending this video without putting on some highlight. So let's do that really quickly. I'm gonna go right back into this palette right here and grab the highlighter. And I just am curious what your favorite part of all of this was, you guys. Do you like an orange bright lip? Do you think I should have done more of a matte, nothing on the lid kind of a thing? I really feel come summertime, that would be a cute, simple, easy look, like very basic skin, not much on it, bright orange, mascara liner, that's it. Like, I love that kind of a look too, but I really wanted to test out a bunch of these products today, and ooh, that is gorgeous. And just kind of put them to work on camera together for the first time. After, you know, unpackaging everything. And again, I am doing one ginormo giveaway, and you can check that out in the PR unboxing if you wish to enter. Really simple to do, and I will have the video linked below so you guys can go check it out. Wow, it is a really good makeup day. I don't know that I favor the foundation as much as my Beauty Blender now that it's been on my skin for a minute, and I will tell you why. It's already getting a little bit oily. Now, if I play around and figure out a different primer to work with it, I will let you guys know. And that might just be me because I have combination skin. I don't have dry skin. And even though they say it's for every skin type, it is a little bit more on the dewy side. And I did notice that I was like, ooh, I might need to repowder my forehead already. And I haven't really even been out of this space, like out doing my normal daily things. You know what I'm saying? So that's not a good sign, but it did go on like a dream. And some people want a more luminous finish. So that's just gonna be your personal preference. Everything else, I am shocked that I like it so much, like everything. I think, you know, the only one that I'm looking at going, would be that pure bronzer that has more of a sheen to it. But beyond that, everything was so nice. This has to be one of the best makeup looks personally that I feel I have done in a while. I just really, really love it so much. I am not doing anything that exciting today. Maybe I'll go grocery shopping or go grab a Starbucks or do something, but basically I'm just here. So nothing that fabulous, but at least I feel really good and I have put these items to the test and I kind of know what I want to try more of. So let me know in the future what you guys want to see. I know that there was a big box of Wet n Wild. There are some other things that didn't make it into the mix of this look right here today, but please keep your requests coming. I love hearing from you guys. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, ring the bell, subscribe, do those things, go enter my giveaway, go have a good one. I love you guys so, so much. And thanks for hanging out with me. I will see you all in my next video. Mwah.